Hello, this is the Sony ZV-1 camera mounted on a gimbal, but I don't think on YouTube the camera is particularly important. I don't think you can tell much of a difference. So I'm going to see what happens when we compare the Sony ZV-1 to other cameras. So here I'm walking with the Sony ZV-1. I'm recording in 4K and I'm using a gimbal, and I'm going to repeat this motion with other cameras. So this is camera A, and I'm repeating exactly the same motion. I'm going along, walking with a gimbal, and I'm doing a pan shot over the logs. And this is camera B, and again, I'm going to repeat the same motion, walking along with the gimbal and doing a pan shot over the logs. And this is my third camera, camera C, and it was a little bit bumpy here. The wind was blowing all over the place. We've just had Storm Eugene in the UK, and I filmed at the wrong time maybe. But again, I'm going to repeat the motion and we're going to see what happens. So let's talk about what the cameras were. So camera A, the first non-ZV-1 camera, was the iPhone 13 mini, filmed using Filmic Pro. Camera B was the DJI Osmo Pocket 2, and camera C was the Canon 200D with a 24mm f2.8 lens. So all of those cameras filmed in 4K apart from the Canon 200D, and I think it was actually very difficult to tell those cameras apart, particularly on YouTube. So what does that mean for the ZV-1? Doesn't mean much for the ZV-1. I like the ZV-1 because it is a convenient camera to use, but it does mean that the camera isn't the be-all and end-all of making videos. And perhaps the best camera is, as everyone says, the one you have with you at the time.